Today we're going to do 4.3, which is solving systems of linear equations by addition. You'll generally hear me say elimination, because that's the term that a lot of other books use. What I need you to realize is it doesn't matter which technique you're using, graphing, substitution, or elimination, you should get the same exact answer. There are certain problems it's easier to do one versus the other. Please, on your test, make sure you read carefully to see what method they expect you to do to solve to get full credit. So elimination, the goal for that is that you actually are trying to get one of the variables to cancel out. And so what I mean by that is you have a negative 5x and a positive 5x so that they cancel out. Or a negative 2y and a positive 2y. So we can multiply equation by anything we want to as long as we multiply the whole equation by it. The same thing as when we're clearing fractions. So we want to cancel, and it doesn't matter if you're canceling the x or the y. Remember, my goal is to get a ordered pair, an x and a y, as my answer. So we're going to start off looking at example 1. Example 1 already has it in the format so that if I add these two, I'm going to get 5x, the y's cancel, and I get a negative 10. Your goal with elimination is to get an equation with one variable that we know how to solve. So now we divide both sides by 5, and we get a negative 2. Don't fall in the trap. Make sure you finish the problem, which means plug it back into one of the original problems. So I'm going to use a 2x plus y equals negative 3. I'm going to plug in for my x, so I get a negative 4 plus y equals negative 3. Add 4 to both sides, which gives me a positive 1. My answer for the problem is the x comma y, remember, so it's negative 2 comma 1. That's my solution for this problem. If you want to check this, which is highly recommended for a test, plug it back into the original problems and make sure it works. I at least would take it, and since we used the second equation, which is what I did in green, plug it into the first one. We didn't use it on our last step, so double check it that way. Number 1 was pretty straightforward because there's nothing I had to do to get an elimination to happen. But looking at number 2, I will have to do something to be able to get these two to cancel. Because right now, if I add them together, it doesn't work. So I either want the x's to be opposite or the y's. And in this case, it's a toss-up. It's up to you on what you want to do. I'm going to multiply and cancel and get rid of my x's. So I'm going to multiply this whole equation by 2. So I'm going to bring the top equation over. And notice I like to draw an arrow so it tells me what I'm doing. The bottom one I'm multiplying by 2. So double check, I get negative 6x plus 8y equals, and if I multiply 36 times 2, I should get 72. Now they cancel. I can add down, so I get 6y equals, this would be 51. So now I need to divide both sides by 6. Now, you are expected to simplify if you can. You know 2 doesn't go in the top and the bottom, but in this case, 3 divides in the top and the bottom. So 3 goes into 6 2 times, 3 goes into 5 1 time with 21 left over, which gives me 17 halves. It's ugly, but it can happen. So now I'm going to take this answer, which is for my y, and plug it back into one of the original equations. So I'm going to take the top one. There is not a right or wrong answer there. So I'm going to have 6x minus 2 times, plug in what I got, which was 17 halves. The advantage, at least here, is that these twos here will cancel. So I end up with 6x minus 17 equals negative 21. I'm going to add 17 to both sides. So when I add 17 to both sides, I should get a 4. but be careful. It's a negative 4. Super easy to make that mistake, especially because right now I'm running out of space. So please be careful there. And so my last step, divide both sides by 6, which gives me a negative 2/3 as my simplified answer. So my answer here is negative 2/3, 17/2. Not a pretty answer, but it is an answer that's possible. And if I were to check it, what you would want to do is the equation I did not just use. So over here in green, I used the top one. At least plug it into the second one. On the test, this is a 5 or 6 point problem. It's super easy to make a mistake on. A lot of people forget again that it's an X and a Y coordinate. So please double check yourself. So going to number 3. In this case, I have to multiply both equations by a value. So if it's easier to do the X or the Y, do it. In this case, it isn't. So I'm going to multiply one equation by a value and another one by another one so that they cancel out. So I'm going to multiply this top one by 3. And I'm going to multiply this bottom one by negative 2. So that is going to give me, I'm going to draw a line here so that you can see what I'm getting. When I multiply the top one by 2, I'm going to get 6x plus 9y equals, and be careful here, this would be 57. And when I do the negative 2, please be careful of the sign, negative 6x plus 14y equals a positive 12. I'm going to fix that 57 right there so you can see it clearer. So now I've designed them. That's the design, so that one of the variables cancels out. So when I add down, I'm going to get 23y equals, and again, I'm going to add these two together, which is going to give me 69. Divide 69 by 23, and you get 3. We now need to take this y value and go back to the original. Plug it into either one that you want to. So again, it's up to you. In this case, one of them is not really easier than the other. So I'm going to plug in the 3. This gives me 2x plus 9 equals 19. Subtract 9 from both sides. I get 2x equals 10. X equals 5 because I divide both sides by 2. So my answer is 5, 3. Make sure you list your X first and then your Y. And because I used the top one, if I wanted to check, I would plug it into that 3x minus 7y equals a negative 6. Going to number 4. In this case, I would only need to multiply the top one because I can get them to cancel. So if I multiply the top equation by 4, I'm going to get 8x plus 4y equals 24. Bring across the second equation. And when we have this, in this case, you should notice both variables cancel out, as well as the right-hand side. This is a special case because the variables disappear, and it's true, which means that the original problem were the same equation with just one being a multiple of the other. So there are infinite solutions. And truly how we write our answer is, it is an ordered pair, because remember, that's what I'm actually trying to get every single problem, such that, and you write down one of the equations. You will have a special case on your test. So last problem here really throws people off. They look at this problem, they're like, I don't even have an idea what to start. Before you try to deal with getting a piece to eliminate, let's just get rid of the fractions first. And the thing that people get confused on is they don't have to be multiplied by the same thing. Remember, you just have to multiply the whole equation. So I'm going to multiply the top one by LCD of 2. So make sure you're doing every single piece. So that's going to be a negative 2x minus y, because those 2's will cancel, equals 5. Double check that. You can write it times 2 for each term as well if you need to see that. For the second one, I'm going to multiply by 6 to clear that one. And so that's going to give me an x minus 3y equals 0. 6 times x over 6 would give me 6x over 6, which is 1x. Here I get 6y over 2, which is going to be a minus 3y. 0 times anything is 0. So this here is my new equations to look at. Ignore that we dealt with fractions in the beginning, but if that first step is wrong, the whole problem is wrong. So now if I look at this, I can multiply this bottom equation by 2 to get them to cancel. So I'm going to bring the top equation down. This second equation, I'm going to get 2x minus 6y equals 0. 2x minus 6y, 0 times 2 is 0. So now I can add them because now they cancel. So I get a negative 7y equals 5. So my y is equal to a negative 5/7. Don't stop there. Let's go back. And I'm going to use, again, I'm not going to use the fraction one, even though, again, that is the best thing to do. I'm going to use my part that has gotten rid of the fractions. So I have x minus 3 times a negative 5/7 equals 0. Put 3 over 1. So this is going to give me x plus 15/7. Because I multiply and the signs are going to be a positive when I multiply negative times negative. And so now subtract 15/7 from both sides. So my answer for this problem is negative 15/7, comma, negative 5/7. Truly, to check this problem, you would need to go back up here. But you could use your calculator for sure, and you could type it in and see that it works. On your test, you're going to be asked to show your work using all of the methods. You can check yourself using a second method, but you have to have the correct method to get full credit. You may get credit from My Math Lab, but the instructor will look back to grade your paper.